Greetings everyone. In this video I am going to describe you vending machine control card developed by Adolf Solutions Pvt. This control card has a power section and a control section. The power section is an SMPS. This SMPS is designed specifically to have the least EMI possible, and the power rating is high. The output current this SMPS is capable of providing is 2 ampere. This control card comes in two variants. One is compatible with a 12 volt VRLA battery, and another is an 8.4 volt 2 cell LiPo battery with all protection and BMS. All the ESD sensitive devices are shielded by this LCD here so as to avoid any accidental damage due to electrostatic discharge. The backside of this control card, there are connectors. This connector is for a battery. You can insert a VRLA battery, 12 volt VRLA battery, or a LiPo battery. This sock slot is for coin acceptor. There are four channels for motor or actuators. There are four channels for feedback sensor. This slot is for the mains 230 volt, and this power section is capable of handling input from the range 80 volt to 265 volt AC. This is a multi-purpose switch. What are the purpose of this switch depends on what application it is, so it will be elaborated shortly. The battery can be put offline just in case if you have to travel the control card or your whole vending machine and don't want the battery to discharge, so you can just put it offline, and again at the time of installation you can put it online again. Now let's see how to configure this control card. In order to configure this card, you will require a battery, and while connecting a battery you should follow the polarity. This terminal needs to be negative, this to be positive. And after pressing this switch, the circuit will be powered. And to put this control card in configuration mode, you will have to keep this pressed, this multi-purpose switch pressed while you are powering up the system. So all you have to do is to keep this pressed while powering up the system, and when you do this you will see a message setting on the display. So you will keep the multi-purpose switch pressed until you see settings here. You release the button. It will ask you for number of channels you are going to use. Now remember, this control card supports up to 4 channel, but user can connect any number of channel he wants in the range 1 to 4. And how many channels we are employing depends on what is the value we set. And in order to change this value, you have to give a short press on this multipurpose switch, and after every short press it will change the value. Let us say I want to set my channel value to 2. So by pressing the switch short pulses, I'll set 2 here, and then I'll give a long pulse. So by keep this pressing for a little while, you can confirm the number of channels. Now for each channel it will ask you two parameters. One is the cost of the product in the channel. Second is the number of quantity in the selection. So cost can be changed. Now we are setting the 10th position of the cost. You can set the cost in the range 00 to 99. So I'm going to set this cost to, let's say, 6 rupees. So I'll set this 10th position to 0. Long press again, it will go to the 1's position, and I'll set 6 here. Again, long pulse will move me on to setting the quantity. Now let us say quantity is 10. So all I have to do is to set 1 here and 0 here. Long press will now change the selection. Now it will ask for the selection 2. Selection 2 cost, let us say, is 10 rupees. So I'll make this 1. Long press, make this 0. Again, long press. Quantity, let us say, is let's say the quantity is 1. So I'll have to set the 10th position 0. Long pulse, set the 1's position 1. And now this setting is related to the position feedback sensors. Now the position feedback sensor will be on the notch position or a notch position. So depending on that, we'll keep it to white surface and set by long press. Now put the sensor on black and the reading is 00. I'll again long press to confirm. It says set. Now it shows 2 selections. First selection cost 6, quantity 10. Second cost 10, quantity 1. It will show the messages. Again, the quantity is not yet set, so I'll long press on the same multipurpose switch to refill. So how I do it? A long press, it will ask me for the menu. So whether I want to refill, short pulse, I'll change it to accounts. What account does is it shows me what are the statistics so far. And finally is master reset, right, to clear the accounts. So what I'll do is I'll say refill. A long press on this will refill. Now again, the stock has been refilled 10, and this stock less for product 2, this message appears because the stock in the product 2 line is too low, it's just 1. So that's why this message. Now we'll see the working of this coin acceptor. The motors, feedback sensors, battery, all are connected and in position. We'll switch the circuit on and see how it works. So showing all these messages. Now I select the second selection. Just as I select the second selection, the coin acceptor starts and it is asking for 10 rupees. Now see, you have to insert the first coin at least in first 30 seconds, or otherwise it will be timed out. I'll start with inserting a 5 rupees coin. I have inserted 5 rupees coin. It is asking me to insert 5 rupees more, and now the time given for timeout is 60 seconds. What I can do is I can insert five 1 rupees coin. Every time I insert a coin, the countdown starts again from 1 minute. So again, 3 rupees more, 1 more coin, please tell me. 2 rupees more, 1 more coin, ask for 1 rupee more, and finally when I insert the last coin, the motor starts rotating and it shows processing on the screen. When the pad is dispensed, it shows please collect the product, and it again shows the available count. Now available count is 00 because initially it was just one product in the selection 2. Now if I try to press the selection 2, it will say out of stock and can't proceed. Though stock 2 is empty, but selection 1 still has 10 items in the stock. So now we'll select selection 1. Selection 1, the cost of selection 1 was 6 rupees if you remember the settings. So I'll insert a 5 rupee coin. Again I'll insert a 1 rupee coin. Again the motor will start rotating. The processing and the card is dispensed. So available count in selection 1 is now 9. Again I'll select the same. It's asking for 6 rupees. It starts the coin acceptor. ₹1 I inserted. Again I'll insert a 5 rupee coin. The motor has start, it will show processing bar and the card is dispensed. Now the total number of products in selection 2 was 1. The total number of products in selection 1 I dispense is 2. So total rupees I got should be 12 from selection 1 and 10 from selection 2. So if I ever have to see the statistic, all I have to do is long press the multipurpose key and it will show the menu. It will start refill. We already used this option. I'll go in accounts now. So when I'll long press this, it will show me total products 3. Total cash available is 22, 10 from selection 2 and 12 from 2. Customize is channel 1, total products dispense 2. Channel 2, total product dispense 1. Total cash is 22 rupees and total product is 3 rupees. Finally, it is showing error, because this control card is capable of connecting to SD card and it can also write values in SD card, and the content of SD card, there is a log data, and if you open the log data you will see the number of products. Product 1, number of product went is 2, cost is 12. Product 2, number of product went is 1 and cost is 10. Total number of product went is 3 and cost is 22.